Course B2, A7. Here is LearnNX with the topic all about arrangements. This video shows you how to use the arrangements command to show different positions of the parts. Every position will be called by a name. If you are new here and want to actively participate, you should also take a look at the first courses. You can find the links in the description. Let's go. Control distance with arrangement. The assembly was provided with constraints in the last course. The slider could be moved via the constraint distance. Now various positions are to be given names and saved. After clicking on arrangements and then on new arrangements, any number of names can be entered. Of course, these are always created in the active assembly. In the arrangements, the distance can now have a variational, specific value. Simply right-click on the constraint and select Edit in Arrangements from the context menu. First, the setting specific is selected for the constraint up and down. And already different values can be entered for up and down. And after clicking OK, the arrangements up and down can be opened anytime here via arrangements. Or here in the context menu of the assembly navigator. In the position column, the display changes as a hint that these parts are controlled via arrangements. To see which arrangement is active, activate the arrangement column in the assembly navigator and move it under position. Subassemblies with different arrangements. Arrangements allow subassemblies that have been installed several times to be displayed differently. The slider is installed in a higher level assembly. Then a copy is quickly created with move component. And unpack all makes both copies selectable in the assembly navigator. Now a different arrangement can be selected for each copy. And if the standard arrangement is selected again, both copies behave synchronously again. Hierarchical arrangements. That means, arrangements in the main assembly controls arrangements in subassemblies. Here in the main assembly, four arrangements are created. Both down, both up, right down and left down. Now the arrangements are switched active one after the other and the suitable arrangements are always selected in the subassemblies. NX has now stored in the main assembly. Which arrangement is to be shown in the subassemblies? Well, this is how the various end positions of entire machines can be controlled. Simple, isn't it? Switching constraints with arrangements. So far we have only changed values via arrangements and thus the position of the parts. However, the position can also be changed in principle with arrangements. For this, the constraints are generated only in the context of a selected arrangement. For example, a screw is to be installed differently in this small plate. For this purpose, the two arrangements, top left and bottom right, are created in a higher level assembly. If the plate is now fixed, you can select under arrangement whether the plate is fixed in all arrangements or only in the active arrangement. Of course, the plate should be fixed in all arrangements. Now the screw is added. This is to be positioned according to the names of the arrangements. So the arrangement bottom is activated. And the screw is positioned with align/lock. But this time with the setting apply to use. Then the other arrangement is activated, and the screw is linked to the other hole. Again with the apply to use setting. In this way, components and subassemblies can be positioned completely individually per arrangement and variants of the assembly can be created. Suppress parts with arrangements. The mounting plate and the mounting material are spare parts and are to be optionally hidden. In the assembly B2, A1-2 the arrangement without spare parts is created, because over this assembly the control is to take place. The spare parts are selected. Then the controlling assembly. The arrangement. And finally always suppressed. And already the visibility of the spare parts can be controlled via the arrangement. And as we will see in a moment, also in drawings or parts lists. And the visibility in the assembly navigator is set here. Arrangements in the drawing. Views of a drawing can also show different arrangements. I create a new drawing. Depending on the default settings of NX, a view is created immediately. I cancel this process. One more thing, in the assembly some parts are on layer 3, therefore layer 3 is also activated. Now a basic view is created. and under Arrangement to use, the created arrangements can be selected. If no other views have been derived from this view yet, like section views or projected views, the arrangement can be changed. After clicking on the frame of the view, click on Edit and select another arrangement. Drawing view without suppressed parts. The assembly B2A1-2 is to be shown in the drawing with or without spare parts. In the drawing, the automatism is cancelled again and layer 3 is activated. Now two basic views are created. One without spare parts. And one with spare parts. Parts lists without suppressed parts. Parts lists can also take into account the missing spare parts. The arrangement without spare parts can also be selected here. And after a double click on the upper left corner, the arrangement can be changed again. Arrangements with absolutely positioned parts. Even parts lying absolutely in space can be positioned individually via arrangements. Again, a small example. I create a small assembly with two components. In one component, I create a block. And in the other, a cylinder. Both parts are positioned absolutely. As already known, first the two arrangements cylinder on block and block on cylinder are created. Then the cylinder on block arrangement is activated. With move component, the components are now moved. Again, you can choose whether the movement is done in all arrangements or only in the active one. I position the cylinder on the block. Then I change the arrangement and position the block on the cylinder. Thus, even absolutely positioned parts can have alternative positions. This is because every movement only occurs in the context of the active arrangement. Oh yes, if you want to place the block exactly on the cylinder, You can also work with constraints in the Move Component command. Simply select the By Constraints setting under Motion. Now the components can be positioned exactly, but by clicking OK, these temporary constraints are deleted again. Conclusion. Position items can be named with arrangements. In addition, subassemblies and parts can be shown and hidden in 3D, 2D and parts lists. Did everything work? If you still have questions about arrangements, post them in the comments. Did you like the video? Then motivate us with your subscription.